You can't help but love somebody like David, because the second you meet him, you know that you're meeting David. He's not, there's no uniform there. There's no facade. It's like, that's David. And his mind is going on in a million directions at once. And it's almost like he's working on, you know, string theory and a symphony at the same time in his head while he's talking to you.
I love talking about music to him. I mean, almost better he than anyone else I know.
He's very patient and he's very intense. He sits really close to televisions. Is the prize? He's really close to a flat screen like this.
He's constantly writing music and listening to it at the same time, and then, you know, speaking, carrying on a conversation. That's my take on David.
The speed of his brain is sort of frightening. It's frightening to be around. He can't stop. It's like it's going like this. I think if he calmed down for a moment, he'd explode.
I think he's very easy working with most people. I think that that's why he's had the career that he has, because he's very good at communicating music, which is something that's not easy to communicate. It's this sort of amorphous a thing that people think they know about, but really don't. And so I think sometimes it's very difficult for directors to really verbalize what they want in a movie. And I think David has a good way of sort of tapping into what the director's sensibility is and giving him the kind of support musically that he needs and that the movie needs.
There are a lot of great composers in the world, and in order to feel happy with your own work, you have to find the person that really connects with you. And, you know, David's the guy.
Galaxy Quest required that you do two things at once, that you absolutely commit to a score that is real, that's about the emotions of that kind of big bombastic movie, but is also an ironic send-up of it at the same time. And it's a very, very difficult thing to do. He pegged it immediately, so there was no work involved. I just sat back and went, this is good. Good. Keep doing that. It was quite an amazing experience.
Comedy's kind of difficult to know what to do. I mean, you don't write funny music for it for the most part, and those pictures need someone like, you know, David. Alan Silvestri does them, but they're not a particularly grateful kind of job to have had. You know, you don't get the Nobel Peace Prize for doing Dr. Dolittle 4, but you might get a Purple Heart for it. You know, they're hard.
It was so appropriate and so right. I can't think of my movie with another score.
The first movie that Willard and I produced when we started our company was an animated movie called The Brave Little Toaster. And I think really the kind of music he wrote for Brave Little Toaster has become the standard now for animated movies, which is animated movies are movies, not just silly cartoons.
He let me conduct one day. You know, the orchestra goes along with it. You know, he's the conductor. He can do anything. He says, get up. They get up. He sit down. They sit down. They play. You know, Danny's going to conduct this one piece. It was, you know, really a joy to be in front of, like, hundreds of guys. Excuse me. I just choked on my own spit.
It was life-changing to watch this cat work. It was just amazing. He with the musicians and his staff, just there was nothing there. And then look at my movie, and there's music there that wasn't there. It was fascinating. It was wonderful. I brought everybody that I knew. Look at what they're doing. There's musicians listening to the guy with the sticks.
In Hoffa, we had such a great time because it was so rich and so full of emotion. And just it brought so much to the movie. It gave me just textures that I you know, was trying for, but you can't get until somebody really lifts it up and puts that foundation under it, and that's what music does.
David, congratulations. I don't know why you don't show up for these awards. There are millions of them people want to give you, and you deserve all of them, and especially this one. Congratulations. Giant big love in your direction.
Hi, Dave. Congratulations. It's very well deserved, and I'm sure that you'll be getting many more of these if they allow that.
David, congratulations. It's been great knowing you all these years. We've had great fun, and you deserve this.
Congratulations on the Richard Kirk Award. You did great. You deserve it.
David is a friend of mine. He's getting the Richard Kirk Award. Yeah, da, 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 da,
da. All my love to you, and have a great evening, and good luck with your speech.